Hidden inside a lab in Sweden, scientists are growing the building blocks of the human body. They're called mesenchymal stem cells, cells that can repair tissue, reduce inflammation, and could one day help cure diseases previously never thought possible.
The special thing is how MSCs attach to the surface and then they start to grow. In a really good batch, we can get out 5 to 6 billion cells.
Malin is here to see how decades of stem cell research are being transformed into the future of healthcare. This is Cellcolabs, a biotech company with the goal of making advanced stem cell treatments more accessible around the world. Producing these cells safely and at scale has always been the challenge. Today, Malin is being shown around the lab by Lena Cervik, who's showing her how Cellcolabs is working to fix this issue.
How does the stem cell from here to be collected and also to be made? What are the process?
First, what happens is that we have a young person within 18 and 30 years come across our website, for example, and say, hey, I want to donate my cells. And on the donation, they go to our clinic and it's our doctors and our nurses who are there, and they take the bone marrow aspiration from the hip, the iliac bone back here. It takes maybe 20 minutes. So when you do the collection from the bone marrow, you can get some other cells as well. But the special thing is how the MSCs are selected is that they attach to the surface in this bottle, and then they start to grow and expand. And then we watch them, and we have a microscope inside. And when they have covered the surface, then we talk about confluences. When they have covered the surface, so it's almost 100%, but not less than 70%, we can de-attach the cells. We put an enzyme inside so the cells let go from the surface, and then we can move them to an even bigger surface. Okay. And that's how the expansion happens. When we do that, we need to be inside here because the cells need to be perfectly sterile and we need to handle them aseptically. When they then handle the cells, they move all the material inside this biosafety cabinet, because in there we make sure that there are no particles at all. So, I mean, in this cultivation vessel, you take off the lid and you can pour out the media that is wasted, like the spent media, where they have used all the nutritions, but the cells are still attached to the bottom, and then you can pour on new fresh media and they can grow even further. In a really good batch, we can get out like 5 to 6 billion cells. We normally say that from one donation, we can get out about 200 standard doses in the end. As it is right now, this facility can produce up to 2,000 standard doses a year. To do that, we would need like 10 donors maybe. So this biosafety cabinet, that's where you do the open handling of the cells. It's an A grade, meaning that we have no particles at all inside this. It's only his hands that are sticking inside. So we are checking all over the room. He's checking this transfer cabinet, he's checking the biosafety cabinet. They will also sample on the table, they will sample on the floor, inside the incubators, in the centrifuge, to make sure that the cleaning that we have performed is
To do this job, do they need to have a lot of experience?
To be able to be certified to work in our process, you need to go through certain steps. Like first you need to be GMP certified, you need to be gowning certified, meaning that you need to be certified that you are able to dress this way without causing any particles. So actually it's a training and then it's a test. So you do all this, you gown yourself, and then our QC department puts these plates on you to make sure that you haven't generated any particles.
Oh.
And you need to pass that test to be certified to go inside. This takes about 6 months actually to be fully certified to be able to work in here.
When a donor gave their bone marrow, are they going to get financial rewarded?
In Sweden, you're not allowed to pay the donor. We do cover like if they needed to take a cab to the clinic and if they were working, so they get some like a coverage contribution for missing work time and like if they needed to pay for something to get to the clinic, but they don't get any a reward for doing it. That's against Swedish law, actually. Okay.
And what are the typical donors' job or their...
For me, I just get a number. I don't know who the donor is. So I just got, okay, this is the batch number. And then I just get to know that it's approved. But I don't get to know whether it's like the sex or the age or anything about the donor. The only persons knowing that is our medical person. So the one responsible for the our CMO and our doctor that actually takes them. They are the only one allowed to know. I just wanted to show you. This is actually like the cell factory that they grow in. So you can see it's 10 layers. And on each surface, that's where the cell grow. And we can, as I said, in one batch, we can have 24 of these. And you can feel it's quite heavy.
Oh, yeah.
And it contains also, when you have the cells in there, you have also 1.5 liters of cell media, meaning that this, it's like, to work, and then imagine that you're sitting in this biosafety cabinet in this position, and you're not allowed to take your hands out, and you pour out the media, so it's kind of a heavy work.
Yeah.
And you, so people in production need to be quite fit.
You said the cells are like us, they eat, they have life.
Yeah.
How can you differentiate a live cell to a cell that maybe in the culture they already dead?
First of all, if you look at them in the microscope, if they are dead, they are not longer attached. So they actually are loose in the media. So you could actually see, you could see dead cells, you could see cell debris in the media. But then when we do count the cells, you stain them with tryptin blue. And if you have a live cell, the cell is intact and you have the cell membrane, and they don't, the stain doesn't go into the cell. But if they are dead, they don't have the membrane left anymore, meaning that the cell got stained. So when you then look in the microscope, you can see blue dots, meaning that they are dead, and you could see round, bright cells, meaning that they are alive. The typical morphology of an MSC is that you have the nucleus or the core of the cell, it's round in the middle, and then it looks sort of like a flashed fried egg. We say it's spindle shaped. It's like having, it's going out like this. That's the sort of typical shape of the MSCs. But cells are live material. You can think that you do exactly the same one day, but one donor cell, they grow a little bit quicker or a little bit slower, so you can't really do exactly the same all the time. And you can't really predict that if we have this amount in the beginning, we will get this amount in the end. It varies a lot, actually.
The stem cell treatment, could you tell us if an audience who don't know to do it, what are the things they need to all look for the first step?
The most important thing is that to make sure that the facility that they are produced in, or the company that they produced in, is GMP compliant. To be GMP compliant and have the approval, the certificate from your authority, it's really important to know that it's high quality cells, of course.
Is that possible that we look at MSC cells in the microscope to see their form and how they look like?
Yeah, as we don't have production right now, I can show you pictures. We have a lot of pictures, so I can show you on the computer how they look like. And I mean, they are taken from inside here, from the microscope.
After the lab tour, Melene sits down with Lena to look through images showing each stage of stem cell harvesting.
So Lena, what are we looking at?
This is a picture of the MSCs. This is actually a picture from one of our microscopes from production when we are in the middle of a batch. So this picture could be from day 3 or 4 in a cultivation. Okay, so what we see here is just after isolation, maybe the day after or two. So the cells hasn't really attached to the surface yet. You can see that they start attached, they start to stretch out like this. What these images shows me and my personnel is that all the cells are round. This is when we have isolated the MSCs from the bone marrow. And we look at them and just see that, yes, we can see that we have cells here. It's a good thing that they are this bright. That shows that they are alive. This is the next step, as I said. You can see that they have attached. They start to be this stretchy. This is what we call this spindle-shaped form. That is one of the quality parameters that we have, of that they do have the right morphology, meaning that they are this spindle-shaped. You can see this is maybe the first time when we will do a medium exchange. So here you can see that they have attached, they are more stretchy. We talked that they have, maybe this is like 10% confluency of the area. And then you can see here, they are even more attached. So that this is how they start. They start in these colonies and they start to fill out the surface. And then as it goes, as we expand them further, we look at them every third day, and then we see here, yes, more of them are attached, more of them have covered the surface. Here we could say they are like 30 to 40% confluent, and we want them to be more than 70% confluent, but less than 100% confluent when we harvest them. And then I think I have a picture here, when you see it's fully, the surface is fully covered, you can't see any space. Almost any space. You can see a little bit space here. Here the cells are ready to be harvested when they have covered the whole surface. And either give them, put them in a bigger surface, like a big, like, so maybe we go from this one layer cell factory that I showed you to the 10 layer cell factory, meaning that they will again look like this single cells, attach and start grow. When we do the final harvest, we concentrate them and we aliquot them in vials containing 40 million cells in each vial. Oh,
40 million.
Yeah, so it's 4 milliliters, it's 10 million cells per ml, so it's 4 milliliters in each vial. And we, for one dose, we thaw 3 of those vials. So 100 million cells is one systemic dose.
Maylene has seen how years of research are being transformed into real-world innovation. Cellcolabs is showing what the future of regenerative medicine could look like, where stem cells help the body heal itself.
Thank you for watching this new episode of HumanWare Project. Please like and subscribe. Your support means the world to us.